Welcome to this session on Unified Endpoint Management for Enterprise Devices. My name is Sumedh Rubasingha. Before starting Entigra, I was the director of IoT architecture at WSO2. So I joined WSO2 back in 2006 and then started Entigra back in 2018. So I thought like I'll start with a brief introduction about Entigra first. So this is we were founded by the same team that developed the WSO2 IoT and mobile device management platform, and the objective was to like focus on developing MDM and IoT solutions as a separately focused entity. And we are also supporting all the existing WSO2 IoT and MDM customers. And to do that, we are also equipped with an OEM partnership with WSO2 so that we can embed any of the WSO2 technologies within our products and also create new products. So the topic today is having unified API endpoints for enterprise devices. So first I thought I will define what enterprise devices are. Now, in this case, there are two categories that I want to mainly focus on, right? The traditional mobile devices that we see. So you see phones, tablets, kiosks, laptops, different types of scanners that are being used in enterprises for various business related purposes, right? And with a lot of employees bringing in their own devices for work. So most of us use our own personal devices to access work related matters, to access office email, to access office calendars, etc., right? Which is BYOD, bring your own device. And at the same time, there are situations where organizations provide devices to their employees. So that particular device becomes managed by the organization, still owned by the employee, which is corporately owned, personally enabled type of devices. So that's one category of devices. Okay? Then the second category of devices that I want to highlight or focus on is the IoT type of devices that we see. So this includes various types of industrial sensors, different communication gateways that can connect these industrial sensors together, and edge computing modules that do some local processing, CCTVs, and many other sensor type of devices that you would see that enterprises would employ to achieve some form of business functionality. So these are the type of enterprise devices that you are talking about. And statistically, if you look at certain statistics, the adoption of these devices, such devices in the enterprise, is greatly on the rise. Now, for example, this particular diagram from Cisco, it talks about 5.4 billion people, 69% of the global population having mobile phones. Right? Now that is even larger than the number of people having electricity connections. Right? Then this particular diagram talks about number of CCTV deployments per cities. Right? So basically most of these CCTV deployments are either personal deployments or employed at various factories, various business premises to understand what is happening at the ground level. And also this particular diagram talks about total number of active device connections worldwide. So this is 2020 and rest of it is kind of a prediction. Right? Now, here the red part is about IoT devices. And the white area represents non-IoT devices. So all these three examples makes us see that the number of devices that are connected, that enterprises are using, are on the rise. And even if you look at around your enterprises, you would see this. You would see that you're employing various kinds of standard devices, sensors into your businesses in a scenarios. So these devices typically provide the sixth sense for you to understand what happens at your supply, what happens at your production or consumption phases. So if you are like if you are a production house, you like you can use the use different types of sensors to understand okay how your production is going on, right? And at the same time, if you are supplying to someone, you might want to understand where your things are, how they are being delivered, right? Or if you are consumption oriented company, you might want to understand how your how the things that you produce are being consumed at the customers, so that you can ensure that they are being supplied as and when they run out of things. Now, different types of devices help you to understand the sixth sense so that you can optimize your business processes more and more. And this particular adoption, it is also fueled by several other factors that have happened over a period of time. For example, things like, first of all, like your customers are now demanding like a lot more real-time situational state of events. Right? So if you are delivering the pizza, the customer, even though it might be a 10-minute ride, the customer might want to understand where the pizza is right now. Or else the customer might want to understand what is the temperature, right, of the pizza. Right? Or else if you have ordered a taxi, rather than waiting for like 10 minutes for the taxi to arrive, you might want to like understand where my taxi is. Okay? So if you are a production factory, rather than waiting until the end of the day to understand how many pieces your production factory has produced, you might want to understand it on a lively basis, what happens right now. Okay? So that side of things, that's the demand. Okay? But at the same time, this demand is also fueled by the drastic reduction in the cost of devices because of the manufacturing efficiencies, because of new technologies, new fabrication technologies, the cost has reduced. And at the same time, to facilitate this that particular phenomena, the data communication infrastructure has also drastically improved so that you can have large number of devices connected, communicating to one another in an affordable way, so that the bandwidth costs also have become very affordable. And at the same time, once you have the devices, there are plenty of software platforms that allows you to connect to these devices and do application development or business process enhancements. So all these factors have, in some way or the other, have fueled enterprises adopting different types of devices within the enterprise. So what this has caused is an explosion of the number of device endpoints within an enterprise. Okay. So what that also means is your enterprise is now depending on these devices, these device endpoints, to execute some form of business functionality or get a feedback into some form of business process. Which means all these device endpoints now needs to be monitored so that they are working properly and managed. And also you should have an access framework so that you can access these devices probably with privileges, permissions. Now, this is the fundamental problem that we want to discuss today. So what are the challenges introduced by this explosion of devices? So before going to the challenges, let's first take a look at certain typical deployment architecture patterns that are there when devices are involved. So the first one is like the devices could be very intelligent. They could be having their own communication modules. So they are directly communicating into a server side. Where the server side picks up whatever the readings, sensing that the device does, and do some processing. Or else it could be that there's a separate local communication gateway to which all the devices are connecting. And then through the communication gateway, the server side receives the the device data and does some processing. Or else the third pattern that we see commonly is having a local edge computing module where certain types of device processing happens closer to where the devices or sensors are. And then whatever the summarized form of the data from the devices would go into the cloud side. Now, with these deployment architecture patterns in mind, let's take a look at some of the challenges that enterprises face with the growth of devices. First of all, the heterogeneous deployment architecture itself is a challenge, because what this means is devices typically, the sensors typically needs to go into difficult places that you cannot inspect. It can be under a tunnel, it can be in a remote location, right? It can be on top of a hill, it can be deep down in a manhole, right? So now, the moment that these devices gets deployed, they need to be connected. So which means there are complicated wiring architectures, right? And the complicated communication modules that comes into the picture. Now, the challenge there is making sure that all these are like undisturbed, they're working. And what it also means is the traditional network boundary that you saw in enterprise is now expanding beyond the walls of your office. So if you have deployed CCTV cameras, or if you are a manufacturing company, and if you have like 10 factories other than your corporate office, and if you have connected all your factories, and if all of those factories are having sensors, right? Now it now becomes part of the network admin's job to make sure that all the sensors are up and running, working, they are properly managed. And also like ensuring that the network connectivity is there. And making sure that the values that are coming are accurate, the sensors are not degrading, and at the same time, the device has not gone wrong. Somebody has not stolen it and sending some bogus values. Now, all these are challenges that were not there, but now are there, typically to be managed by the network infrastructure team of an enterprise. And then comes the second part of the problem, IDT and access management. Once you have like a large fleet of devices deployed, you need to make sure that a certain type of devices are accessed by a certain type of operators, not the others. So which means you need to have a way of like tying in the human identity with the device identity or human operator identity. And once you have the devices properly access control connected, you need to have application development integration interfaces so that developers can seamlessly keep on working with these devices. And the devices are remote. Time to time, these devices, whatever the logics that run in these devices, needs to get updated, which means the firmware distribution comes into the picture. And at the same time, like sometimes some of these devices can move between locations, which means you need to understand asset tracking with regard to the devices. So these are some of the main challenges that you see, but there can be a whole bunch of other challenges that enterprises will face when the devices come on board. Now, these also get tied up with, if you are a device manufacturing company, these also get tied up with different device life cycles as well. Now, what we have listed here is like some of these life cycle phases, right, and certain type of integration requirements. Because from WSO2 as well as from Entigra, our objective is to allow our customers to seamlessly integrate with different types of endpoints. Right? And the next couple of slides that you're going to see are highlighting some of the integration points that are there, that are required at different phases of device onboarding. So first of all, if you are engaging with the device at the point of it is being manufactured, let's say you have given a custom metering order, or you have given smart meters to be developed, and you want to understand when those smart meters are produced. So which means like there has to be certain API endpoints that accesses, that allows the MAC address, the serial ID to be registered. And certain API endpoints that provides provisioning tokens, certificates to the devices. Right? And if you want to send in a firmware to the device at the point it is being manufactured, you might want to expose those firmware through App Store. And during the quality control phases, you might want to from your system, you might want to offer a temporary provisioning token so the device can access all your systems. And then once the testing is done, you might want to do a remote wipe off or factory reset the device. Now, all these require API integration between your systems and the devices. Then once the device is ready for sale, you might want to understand where the devices are, what's the status in which warehouse. And once the device is sold to a customer, right, you might want to mark that particular device as something that is sold so that it did not get picked up by your sales system. Right? And when it is being delivered, you might want to track where it is, right, through various type of sensors. Right? And when it is installed, or when it is being installed, you might want to verify that the installation is right. So you might want to issue temporary tokens again, or you might want to assign that to a customer or to a particular site. And then you might want to activate warranty when the device is in full operation. Now, all these engagements with devices require integrations with software systems. So what we have done in our product is we have provided certain standard API endpoints that can be used in various life cycle stages of device onboarding. And under production, fault maintenance, and being discarded, there are also certain API integrations that are required. Now, this is basically an higher level overview of the IoT platform, right? And various components that are available that are required for a device deployment. So at the very bottom, we have certain types of firmware that will go into certain known device operating systems so that these devices can connect to API endpoints offered by the server side. And in between, if the devices require certain type of computing that needs to happen, right? And if there are edge computing gateways that needs to be managed, different types of edge computing gateways, we also have an edge computing module that can fit into a very small computing footprint. And on the devices layer, what we have done is we have abstracted out different types of device platforms so that you could be having different types of devices, but the moment that they connected to the server side, all those devices are represented as unified APIs to the applications on top. So that brings us to the topic of this talk, having unified device management endpoints for the enterprise devices. So what this means is with this particular the product platform, you can have various types of devices coming in from various vendors, and you can connect all such devices into a single platform so that you can develop applications on top of these devices in a uniformed way. And also to facilitate some of the application development, what we have done is we have bundled together certain WSO2 components. APIs, I will come back later because that's a key topic. But at the same time, we have bundled the stream analytics component so that if your devices are pushing out a stream of events, we can use this to process that data. And event is the adapter layer so that if there are standard protocols that we support, but at the same time, if you want to deal with a custom protocol, that can also be extended. And the identity and access management component, we have bundled it together so that you can manage the human identities, and through the device management, you can manage the device identities and then correlate these two together so that you can assign operators, owners into the devices. And how we have done this is, like I have briefly mentioned, we have introduced a concept of device type management. So within the IoT platform, you can have different types of device, different device types representing various behaviors, various characteristics that a device would have. So defining a device type can either be done using an UI or else it can be done programmatically. So these are the standard UI that is available for you to define a device type. This is pretty much similar to how you would define a class on a programming environment. You can define a type, and then you can onboard a device, right? So that whenever you define a device, there will be an API, and through that you can onboard a device. And for each and every device type that we create, that you create, there will be a corresponding API that will be presented on the WSO2 API manager, API console that we have integrated. Now, for example, like this particular console shows you some of the standard device management APIs that we have, so that anybody who's connecting devices can make use of some of these standard devices, device management APIs. And at the same time, if you can write your own custom APIs that are related to the device and have them exposed to your developers so that they can seamlessly access the devices. And on top of the same set of APIs, we have also developed a device management console so that for a standard deployment, you don't have to write your own console to understand where are your devices, what their connectivity status is, what are their MAC addresses, etc. So that like there's a standard module that is available that you can reuse. And at the same time, there are standard functionalities like you can group the devices into various demographics. You can create policies so that you know like how certain devices are going to get connected to the Wi-Fi, etc. So there's a standard device management console on top of the same API layer. And for certain known device platforms like Android, Linux, we have standard out-of-the-box set of APIs so that, for example, if you want to mute an Android device, there's a mute API operation that is available that you can directly involve into a connected device to the platform. Same thing for like certain generic functionality like provisioning certain devices, or if you want to enroll devices, like there are enrollment APIs for the devices that are going to get connected. You can, if you want to issue tokens, you can obtain token certificates, right? And there are like SDKs that you can obtain. And then different types of connectors between the devices and the platform. So there are built-in set of generic APIs that are available for this. And the next thing that you face, the next challenge that you face when you have the devices connected is how you distribute applications or firmware into these devices. So for this, what we have done is we have created an extensible firmware application management portal, an app store. So this, which you can use to distribute applications into your devices, and all the capabilities are also available as API endpoints, so that you don't have to use these consoles, but rather push the applications or the firmware updates via APIs, via API calls. And you can have a firmware store as well. And on top of the same platform, same IoT platform, what we have done is we have done a mobile device management solution that specifically targets managing traditional mobile devices or kiosks or laptops. So it's an off-the-shelf product that is available if you are specifically looking at doing mobile device management only. So this brings us to the end of this particular session. Our objective was to give you an overview of what we have done with regard to managing different types of devices as standard API endpoints within your enterprise architecture, so that you can seamlessly onboard different types of devices into your business and make them available for your application developers to develop and enhance your existing processes. So if you further like to understand how we can help you, please drop us a mail at contact@entigra.io. We would be happy to discuss your project and see how we can define a solution architecture for you, and also take you through a proof of concept and see how we can be useful to you. So thank you for your time and attention.